Good evening, my friends. All two of you. Three? Ooh, I have three friends. No, I'm kidding. I mean, I think IRL, I probably have only three friends. But, that's okay. I don't really need too many friends. Oh, one of them left. Damn. Hey, Ollie. I heard your lip smack and got scared. I didn't realize that happened. Alright, so I'm not actually gonna dawdle for too long since, like, last time the stream lagged towards the end of it, so I'm going to just jump right in. Am I one of your three friends? Yes, you are definitely one of my three friends. The background music scared me at first. I'm sorry. I looked up Chopin music. Because since, like, I don't know, I'm going to be painting and stuff, I wanted something chill, relaxing. And what's more relaxing than piano music, right? So I found a video of, you know, Frederick Chopin music, and there you go. I don't know if he's, like, wilding on the piano right now. He usually has some pretty chill stuff. But anyway, let me arrange some things here. I hope everyone had a good week this week. I was going to say today. I hope you had a good week today. Just the entirety of 7 days in one 24-hour period. Because that's possible, right? So I adjusted some things on my end. Hopefully that will result in a smoother stream. So we don't have to worry too much about any kind of lag or something. I mean, that's what I'm hoping for anyway. So we shall see. Oh no, Madeline is disappearing! Ah! Yes, she is now gone. Alright, cool. Pencil. Wait, am I a friend? Absolutely, you are my friend, Moon Puppet. Everyone in stream is my friend. Ollie's my friend. Moon Puppet's my friend. Matt is my friend. Tim is my friend. No, Tim is not my friend. No, fuck Tim. Tim is my mortal enemy. And microwave safe. Fuck that guy. I honestly don't know anybody named microwave safe. I'm just messing. Alright, we'll make Madeline pop in there. So today I was just gonna, I don't know. I don't even know. Just start work on a background of some kind. I gotta be real. This week has been pretty nuts at my job. I am so exhausted. I mean, obviously not exhausted enough to cancel stream, but like, if I sound a bit lower, I don't want a black pencil, I want white. If I sound a little low energy throughout the stream, it's because of that. Like, I'm just kind of tired. But, I mean, lucky for us, painting is, and coloring and stuff is one of the few things that, that keeps me sane, that keeps me, you know, whatever, I guess, going. So I'm just gonna, I don't know, I'm just doing a rough sketch of ideas of what I want. I've got a reference up, I don't think y'all can see it, but I'm just like really roughing it out right now. Just coming up with ideas. Let's see. No, that's kind of weird. You've got a friend in me. They told me I was too young. They told me I needed more training. Are those lyrics to a song, Mystique? Because I don't know what song that is. My dad is probably microwave safe because that's the only thing he uses. I mean, look, I ain't gonna lie. You know, microwaves, I mean, they have their uses. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not gonna dog too hard on microwaves. It is easy to use. I use the microwave every once in a while, you know? It's just, it's quick and easy, you know? It gets the food heated up in a fast time. What the hell was I doing there? That's not what I wanted to do. Let's see. There we go. I'm gonna get my pencil back. No, I don't want a black pencil. No, they're copypasta from the intro to Crypt of the Necro Dancer. Oh, okay, gotcha. Hello, Twilight. Good to see you, my friend. Boomer 100. Hello. Oh. I was holding my stylus upside down. That's why nothing was drawing on. I'm awake and ready for today. All right, let's see. So that's probably going to be the horizon line there somewhere. And I'm going to put some happy little trees back here. I don't know. I'm just going to kind of wing it. And then the sky is just gonna dance up there, and then under the horizontal, we're gonna have, I don't know, some dirt roads maybe. Maybe this will be one dirt road, I don't know, we'll see. And some bushes here and there. So Madeline's gonna go bye-bye, because I don't need her for the reference anymore. And we are going to begin actually rough sketching this thing. Clearly he doesn't own an air fryer. Also can't believe four Lamars drugged and brainwashed Megan Seltzer. You know what? I actually did manage to watch the rest of that new Sunset Paradise episode. And you know what? It did get better. It did get better. I don't know, dude. It tends to start kind of slow. And then it picks up, like, in the last 5 minutes. But, yeah. It's confirmed that nothing else in the kitchen is safe except for the dishwasher. Absolutely. Well, and my fridge. If my fridge wasn't safe, then, like, I wouldn't be able to eat. Oh, my God. Excuse me. Hey Dish, just curious, what program are you using? I use a program called ArtRage. ArtRage. And the reason why? It came with my Wacom tablet. That's literally the reason why I use it. It came a base version of it. Where the hell is my mouse? Oh, there it is. Hey, mouse. Hello. Okay, go away. Yeah, so ArtRage came with my Wacom tablet, and I upgraded to the full version, like, I think last year, and I did so because I was, like, really fucking bored. So, yeah, that's what I use. And I like it. It's not really like your typical Photoshop or Clip Studio Paint. It's more geared towards it's more geared towards emulating traditional media. You know what I'm saying? Like, I have a bunch of pens and pencil tools and paint and stuff, and it does a really good job at emulating how those tools feel like in real life. And I really like that. I mean, I started drawing using traditional media, and this program almost 100% is a pretty faithful recreation of those tools. So that's why I use it. My sister recommended Krita because it's like basically a free version of Photoshop, which, I mean, I've thought about, especially if I want to do more, I guess, commercialized style, you know, works, you know, like something you'd see on a cartoon or an anime series. I'd probably download that, but I mean, for now, you know, to make something that looks more, you know, natural, I guess, ArtRage is pretty cool. Don't forget reference lines to your vanishing point. It helps with distance and scale. No, I totally got you, dude. At this point, I kind of just imagine it, you know? But even if things look kind of weird, I mean, yeah, whatever. It is what it is. Green everything. Yes, green everything. I don't get how anyone draws backgrounds. The only thing I'm good at is drawing anime-style girls. Hey, I mean, that's fine. You know, that's a skill. I'm not good at anime girls. I'm not good at anime, you know, period. I just kind of discovered my style by accident, honestly. But background painting is something that I'm okay at, you know. I'm not a background artist by any means, but I'm okay with it. I'm not drawing a square today, Star Mist. Those are too hard. The only thing I can draw that seems to look cool are patterns. Hey, man, that patterns are, there's a market for that, you know? There's definitely a market for patterns. I mean, look at the clothes that you wear, or most of the clothes that you wear, you know? It's made up of patterns and stuff, so I wouldn't sell myself too short on that. Trees up here, blah blah blah. I use Medibang. I've heard of Medibang. Don't use it myself, but I've definitely heard of it. Let's see, push stuff here somehow. Push stuff here as well. Blah blah blah. Okay. I mainly do traditional drawing. Yeah, I started it with traditional drawing myself. Alright, yeah, sure, why not? I can make thumbnails! That's also a skill. Yeah, that's something. I can make absolutely nothing except writing. Writing's an art. Writing is absolutely an art. Not everybody can do it. Some even say that art is, you know, one of the... art, wow. I'm so tired. Some people even say that writing is, if not the toughest, one of the toughest art forms out there. Again, that's totally up to, like, you know, personal opinion, of course. But no, yeah, art is... Writing is not easy. Okay, now what tool do I want to use? Do I want to use an oil brush? Wow. Wow. Pick a color. A nice shade of green of some kind. Let's see, what does this look like? That's very tiny. Okay. Sorry to brag, but I actually drew the art that is used in this new PFP, and I'm actually really proud of it. Yeah, that looks really good, Twilight. You did a good job. Music is a form of art. Yes, it is. Music is a form of art. It is my strongest art form that I like to engage in. Writing is easy if you only care about making a goddamn mess. Source my immortal. Oh my god, my immortal. What an absolute masterpiece. Okay, so let's see here. So be prepared to just see me kind of, I don't know, maybe mess up a lot. I might erase. I honestly still don't really know what exactly I'm going to be doing here. I'm just kind of sorting, flying by the seat of my pants at this point. You know what? That is a really tiny brush. Let me make it big. All right, cool. Hell, I might just end, like, do nothing but trees, the background trees. It honestly depends on just how I feel later on and stuff. I didn't draw my profile. Someone I'm no longer friends with did. I should change it to Belle at some point. Source of my profile pic is obvious.
The dark web.
I'm just kidding, it's probably not the dark. I hope it's not the dark web. I hope the music choice is alright for you guys today. Was feeling a little classical today. You know what? Am I forgetting where the sun, where the source of light is? Yeah, it's actually coming from the front, so. Alright. Dish mistakes his light source 101. It's okay. The beauty of having this kind of program is you can easily start over. And let's change the green a little bit. Let's make it a little more evergreen type. Wasn't a fan of it. Imagine changing your profile picture. Imagine having a universal label found on dishware as a PFP.
Tonight, I'll be eating fried avocado tacos.
Thank you.
Ooh, you gonna eat that at Leslie Palooza?
What? Who's coming to that?
Everyone coming. Everybody. You, her, me, all of them.
I don't know why, but the music is making me feel uneasy. I can change it if you want. That's not an issue. Or I could turn it off. Or put it down. Here, let me put it down a bit if it's making you uneasy. Boop. Does anyone here have tips on how to feel good about your art a lot of the time? Because honestly, I'm not that great at being proud of my stuff. Like, I'm surprised whenever I am proud. That's, you know, I can only speak for myself. That's just a universal issue with all artists, you know. Because, I mean, you know, there's a big source of pride when you create art. You're making yourself vulnerable. Not only every time you make art, but when you show it to the world. That's why it took me so long just to, you know, have a YouTube channel. It took me so long to start doing these art streams. Because, yeah, I was the same way, but I mean. And honestly, I don't think I'm ever going to get over it. You just have to kind of take that first step and just, you know, kind of do it and show people. And you'll be surprised. You know, you'll get more people that will support you than not, at least in my experience. So, I'm sorry. I guess that really wasn't a tip. My tip is I don't have one. Just, you know, do what you love. And, you know, just try your best. Don't worry if it doesn't come out how you'd want it to. Like, hell, I'm doing this work right now on this one single tree, and it could very well be that I'm not really gonna like it, and I'm gonna erase the whole damn thing. You know, that's one thing that I've also learned big time, is sometimes you'll make something and, like, you'll look at it once it's done, and then you're like, oh god, what the hell did I do? And you just kind of have to start over, you know? It happens, you know? It happens. But yeah, don't... Also, don't let, you know, that fear or that inability to really feel proud of your work keep you from doing it. One day you'll get to a point where you're like, you know what? That was kind of cool. You'll get there. If anything, just, you know, just take, you know, be happy that, you know, you're learning something every time you put pencil to paper or ink to paper or whatever, and every day you're getting better. I'm sorry, everyone, if you like the music. No, it's cool, Boom Puppet. No worries. I have sussy imposter syndrome, so I can't exactly feel good when praised. No, I mean, yeah, like I said, dude, I completely empathize with you there. Hell, I still feel weird when people say good stuff about the music that I make and stuff. But you know what? At the same time, it's really nice, and it keeps me going. So you'll figure it out. Everyone's different. You'll figure out your way of dealing with that stuff. As I'm just kind of blending these lights here on this, I guess I'm deciding to just kind of make these bell trees. It's like a fucking bell. It's bell tree! I mean, you know what? That's not bad. I like it. I might, like, reshape it here and there. Like, I'll probably grab my my eraser tool and just kind of shape it here and there to my liking. I don't know. You know, my approach to art is very similar to music. You know, sometimes I'll have an idea and I'll start on it, and then sometimes it just turns out to be different. Like, what if I did this? And it's like, oh shit, that's kind of cool. And then it just sticks. You know what I mean? Everyone's got their process. As long as you're confident in your process, you know, everything else will fall into place. And where is my water? Here it is. I'm sorry, I'm not keeping up with the chat. Claire wants to VC, so I'll have to go. All right, buddy. Take care. See you around. Hi, Dish. The background looks great so far. Thanks, Honitude. Just started on this one tree. And we'll see what we get done today. I'm not really expecting to get very far. But, I don't know. We'll see. I can acknowledge that my art is good and I like it. I guess I just don't feel the emotion of pride super often. That's fine. That's totally fine, you know? I feel the same way sometimes, you know? Sometimes you just make art and then it's done and it's like, all right, cool. and you kind of move on. You know what I'm saying? It's not like you hate it. It's just, it's done. So, yeah, I totally feel that. And I don't know what that could be for you. For me, that's usually a sign of, goddamn, I've been doing this for a while and maybe I should chill. You know, take a little bit of a break, you know, for a week or so. And then usually when I get back to it, it's like, all right, cool. I'm ready to get back into it, to get excited again and whatnot, you know. But, I mean, yeah, you know, whatever profession out there you want to do, whatever skill or hobby that you pursue, you're going to have days where you're just not feeling it. Self-pride and art is hard. Agreed. All right, let's see here. Let's get weird with our eraser tool. Let me actually make it smaller. There we go. And I'm just gonna kind of go nuts here. Just make some random eraser marks here and there to, I don't know, hopefully mimic some kind of a tree. Maybe I did a little too much in some areas. Here, let me undo. See, you can't do this in real life. You can't undo. I'm still trying to find what form of art I'm actually good at, because I don't seem to be good with drawing anything else. I don't feel super confident in it. Therefore, I don't think anyone else will like it either. Well, I mean, hey, you know what? Big secret, but not really a secret. No one really, like, 99.99% of artists out there don't start off amazing. You know what I'm saying? Most of the great artists that you see and know and love, they got there because they just love to do it. And they just kept pursuing it because they're just obsessed with it. You know what I'm saying? And then over time, obviously, the more you practice, the better you'll get at it, because that's just naturally how things go. So, I mean, as long as you love what you're doing, you're going to get better at it, because you are motivated to get better. You know what I'm saying? If you love to paint, and all you want to do is paint all fucking day, that's exactly what you're going to do. And the more you do it, the better you're going to get. If you do something you don't want to do, you don't give a shit. You know what I'm saying? You're just going to do it because it's an obligation. And that's never a good reason to do anything. My opinion, of course. I mean, everybody's experience is different than mine, and I don't want to pretend like I'm some kind of all-knowing guru or some shit. You feel me? I'm just some dude in his 30s just having fun. Making music and painting for some cool people on YouTube. Speaking of music, sorry if I've asked before, but what program do you use? Also, thank you, Dish. I use the software program that I use is called Cubase. I've been using Cubase for about 5 years now. And again, the reason why is because it came bundled with my audio interface. That just seems to be the thing with me. I was using FL Studio before, but at the time when I got my Mac, the one that I'm currently using right now, FL Studio wasn't working with it. So, like, it wasn't supported on Mac. So I had to change to something else. I didn't know what, But lucky for me, at the time that I got my my interface, you know, Cubase came into my life, and I was like, oh, okay, cool. I guess I'm using this now. And it worked out. All right, now the tree's looking like someone tore, like, shredded paper. So I'm going to go back and just, you know, smooth out some of these little bits and pieces here. And hopefully we'll get something that resembles a bit more like a tree. I mean, as long as it looks good to me, you know what I'm saying? Like, my trees aren't going to be your trees, and my trees isn't going to make everybody happy, you know? Some people are going to hate my trees, and you know what? That's okay. Not everybody's got to like my trees. Not everybody has to like your trees or your art. That's just another reality, you know? Some people just will not and cannot, for one reason or another, enjoy the stuff that you do, and that's okay. A lot more people will. That's what I've learned. Madeline reaches the summit to reach the mystical guru, only to find a dishwasher. And it's out of soap. Did you bring the soap, Madeline? I have strawberries. That'll work. Hey, Dish, what's up? What's good, Bug? Good to see you, buddy. I use Beatbox. I actually got the FL Studio free trial a few hours ago. Good. That's awesome. Like, honestly, I always tell people, like, if they ask me, what should I get FL Studio? It's honestly, you know, the most, I mean, it's not just the most beginner friendly, but like, it also offers free updates for life, and that's really cool. No other program that I know of does that. So yeah, dude, I'm really happy for you. I hope it works out. Tree moment. Feel like tree. Dish is the new Bob Ross. Rest in peace, Bob Ross. I mean, that's funny that you say that, but I mean, let us not, I don't know. Bob Ross is leagues ahead of anything that I can do. See, right now I'm just trying to kind of experiment here, just, I don't know, doing weird shit and seeing what works. Honestly, 90% of the time, any kind of art that you're into, that you're trying to do, that's honestly 99% of your process. It's going to literally be throwing shit at the wall and seeing what sticks. And, I mean, that's... that's just, you know, that's the process, you know? There is no magical formula of any kind that's just going to render out something amazing every time. Sometimes some pieces will take like an hour for you to finish, and it's like, holy shit, the process was so like intuitive that I have all this free time now. And sometimes you're gonna spend 5 fucking hours on one fucking tree. And that's okay. That's okay. This ain't art class. We ain't in school. We just having a good ass time. Just experimenting, just going crazy, and it's looking like a, I don't know. It's looking more like a pyramid now. I'm not exactly in love with the process that I'm going through right now. So we're going to go through the magic of undoing and see what we can figure out. Just got a massive bush bell tree kind of thing. Let's see. So probably what I'm gonna try here is add a little more detail to, like, I don't know, a section of the tree so it looks like there's another branch kind of popping out from somewhere. So it looks less like a bell and probably more like a, like some kind of just bushy tree. That's kind of the feeling I'm going for here. So we'll give that a shot and we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. Joke's on Madeline. The dishwasher has something better than soap. Wisdom beyond your wildest dreams. Nah, it's just old man shit. You should follow a Bob Ross tutorial on this for a future stream. Yeah, maybe. That sounds like fun. Oh man, this headache is really getting to me. Hold on. Oh shit. Yeah, you better take care of that, bug. Especially with the fungus growing in me right now, I have to deal with that. Nah, I'm sorry to hear that, dude. Fun fact, if a dishwasher is able to play music, then it's safe. Therefore, 99% of dishwashers around the world are not safe. Yeah, that sounds about right. Alright, whoops. I forgot I had a brush activated. So let's see here. Let me just add a little dark spots in here, giving the tree a bit more depth. And then we'll kind of blend it in and see how that looks. All right. Let's grab our little blade? Tool? Is that what this calls? Palette knife. Palette knife, that's what it's called. All right, let's see here. Then we'll go in here. Blend this a little bit. Okay. Let's work this in just a tad more. Oh, where did my pen go? There it is. Looks like I might be onto something there. God, I keep losing my my little tool here. Let me actually make it a little bigger. There we go. Actually bring some of this lighter stuff up here to overlap darker stuff, and then we'll keep this kind of shrouded in the dark a little bit. maybe add some of that lighter stuff so it looks like something's behind there. And I think that's going to be the process I'm going to be using for the rest of this tree. If I can find the cursor. There it is. Hello, little cursor. I hate it when you get lost like that because then I look like a fool. Well, a bigger fool than I already am. Let's be real. Not gonna lie, tree is actually looking good though. Thank you. I am kind of just messing around a little bit, like just trying to figure stuff out here. And yeah, it's getting there. It's getting there. This is probably just gonna be the stream. Dish paints a tree. And you know what? That's fine. This is the first painting background that I've done in some time, so you know. If anything, I'll figure out a process today and then just kind of carry that into the rest of the process. And I mean, that's another thing, you know, even if you've been doing something for a long ass time, there's always a room for, you know, discovering something new to either add to the arsenal or to improve what you've already got. Shit, I'm not the best at music. There are lots of things I can do to improve, but you know what? That's okay. It's no reason to feel bad about myself or nothing. It's exciting. Okay, I'm gonna stop. I don't know. I tend to ramble on about shit like that. I apologize. Hope I'm not bugging anybody. I'll just kind of fuck with that up there because it's just kind of lying there. All right, so it's looking like something. I'm tempted to go grab cookies. Must resist. I mean, I don't know. Cookies are kind of important. Not gonna lie. For future reference, as the self-proclaimed CEO of self-deprecation, if anyone in this chat self-deprecates, including me, I will not hesitate to cancel them. Understood. Whenever I watch anyone do art, I always feel that they know what they're doing, although I didn't really think they were just messing around and it just ends up working. Yeah, I mean, there are probably a good number of people out there who do know what they're doing. You know what I'm saying? Because they've been doing it for so long. They just have a process down, you know? But at the same time, you know, sometimes you just do different things and you surprise yourself. I certainly do. So we're going to try to match what we got on that side. And just kind of filter these out a bit. And then we'll add some more detail here and there. We need some more darks. That's what we need. We need a little dark color to blend in there a little bit. So we'll add some here, add a little bit up here, add this. We'll add some here, right here. And then we'll do a little bit down here to kind of blend in down there. And now pull out the palette knife and stab ourselves in the neck. No, we won't. In short, you know the rules, and so do I. Does having mommy issues count as self-deprecation? Only if you self-deprecate yourself over them. All right, let's see here. We'll do this. Yeah, not gonna lie, it's looking kind of weird. Let's undo that. Let's go down here instead. And we'll actually blend this down here so we can get some darkness down here to give the tree a bit more depth. So I'm a lot better painting skies than like foliage, admittedly. Skies are a lot of fun to draw, probably because it's mostly just making poofy clouds. But, yeah, those are fun. What up, Dish? How you doing, homie? What's up, Snappy? I'm doing pretty good. I'm just a little tired. Work this week has been a lot busier than I was expecting, so this is more of a bit of a more chill stream than like my gaming ones, where I'm like cursing out Hatkid or something. No, I'm just kidding. I wouldn't curse out Hatkid. She's precious. But yeah, I'm doing good. Just having a nice chill painting session here. I'm just kind of figuring stuff out, kind of messing around. Making a fat bell tree. It looks like a tree, a pine tree. Cool. As long as it looks like a tree. You know what I'm saying? Peck. Beans! What up, Cam? Welcome to the stream. No beans, though. I had beans yesterday. They were really good. Really yummy. Beans with rice and some grilled chicken with some flour tortillas. Ooh. That was really yummy. Filled me up pretty good. It's Witty. What's up, Witty? Good to see you. what do we got here? We've got a mess. I think the colors that I chose are probably a bit too light. Especially, I mean, if it's on one side, it's fine, but we've got a light source coming from the front here, so. We are gonna mix in some dark around here and blend it in, and hopefully that'll fix some stuff. And if not, you know what? I am not above just starting over. Sometimes that happens. If anything, I'm just exposing myself as the world's worst painter. If more FNF characters join the chat, I'm just gonna laugh internally. Oh, is that what's going on? I had no idea. I just saw more people joining and I was like, hey, cool. More people. I am totally chill with that. What time do we have running? I'm at 51 minutes. Okay, cool. See here. What do we got? Still got a mess. You know what? Let me go back to what I had before. Before I added all this stuff. And let me just work a few more things here and there. Hope everyone had a good week this week. Hope y'all that are on vacation are having a good time. What with the pandemic kind of, you know. I mean, I'm not going to say it's over. It's not over, but it's letting up. So maybe some of y'all are going out, you know, taking a vacation somewhere. I don't know. Speaking of Hat Kid, I finished my 6th playthrough of A Hat in Time a few days ago, and the ending still breaks me. That's cool. I just had spaghetti and garlic bread for dinner yesterday. I don't think I've ever had garlic bread. Really? That's very interesting. Garlic bread is awesome. It is very delicious, especially with some spaghetti. Somebody a touch of my spaghetti. Was that a meme that came out last year or 2 years ago? I don't remember anymore. Memes just kind of blend in for me nowadays. Like, you could quote a meme from, like, I don't know, 2016. And I'll probably still find it funny and be like, oh yeah, that came out like a couple months ago, right? And then people be like, dude, Harambe was shot like 5 years ago. Where have you been? And I'll be like, oh, you're right. Let's see. All right. This is a background tree, so it's like not gonna have any crazy detail to it. So, I mean, for what it is, it gets the job done, you know. You look at this and you're like, yeah, it's a tree. Maybe I could continue playing around with it here and there. And that's kind of the danger of art, too. You could play around with stuff for hours and just never be satisfied with what you have. You know what I'm saying? Like, what's the saying? An art piece is never finished. And there's a lot of truth to that. Hey, paisanos! Here's my test of Dish's opinion on old memes. Sans Undertale. Yeah, that's an oldie. Oldie but goodie. Harambe may be dead, but he's immortalized in meme culture and stock behavior. Yeah, that is true. I don't think the legend of Harambe is gonna die anytime soon. I mean, hell. We're going to be like in our 60s and 70s and like we're still going to be quoting stuff. And can you just imagine the history books that will be written for, you know, the children of the next generation. And it's just gonna be all about, you know, fucking memes. They're gonna be memes in the goddamn history books. That is what absolutely cracks me the hell up. And then we're gonna be spouting memes to our grandchildren, and they're gonna roll their eyes and be like, "Okay, millennial." Gabe the dog. Oh yeah, Gabe was an absolute legend. R.I.P. Gabe. R.I. fucking P. Gabe. Alright, so let me grab my eraser tool and just kind of work some things here. Just kind of mess around. Hey Dish, if we ever play A Hat in Time, do you want to play Beta Hero Challenge or Vaporwave Dream? They're both fun. I think you mentioned something like that last week. And, I mean, I'm totally down for, you know, doing like an online party. I just don't exactly know how to work out the logistics of that. Like, because you can, like, straight up create, like, your own password and shit, right? And then you just share that password and then people can come in. I think that's how that works, right? And, I mean, if that's the case, I mean, that's something that I can even share on stream. And then I'll just wait for people to show up. History class in the future are going to be like, okay, class, we're going to study memes from 2017. They're going to be like, hey, you want to make your grandpa laugh like an idiot? Just go up to him and say, these nuts. And like all the kids are going to be so confused, but we're going to fucking laugh so hard that we just collapse and die.
Ha ha ha.
It doesn't have a password, just an online party name. Okay, yeah, that's... Yeah, I don't know why I said password. That's what I meant. It's got to be an online party name. Yeah. I mean, yeah, I could set that up, you know. I'll come up with a name, and anybody that wants to join, you know, just hop on in and we'll have a blast. A Baja blast. Oh god, there I go again with my Baja blasts. Do. So let's see. If I took this off. Okay. You know what? It's actually not bad. That's not a bad little tree. Took me an hour, but I was mostly figuring shit out, but cool. There's our first little tree of a background for Madeline. And then Madeline's huge! So much bigger than the goddamn tree. Is it bad I know who actually sung the Young Cat song? I don't think so. I think that's impressive. I don't know who sung that song. You're making me wish I had the PC version. Dang. You know, the PC version really is like the version to have. It's honestly the best version of the game. Just for the mods alone. Happy little tree. Can anyone tell me the significance of this image? Shows that one meme where oofed Sayori is dabbing. Oh god. Bro, there's gonna be a day where Sans is going to be in history books. Some poor little 11-year-old kid is gonna sit in world history class, open up to like chapter 420, and he's gonna be bombarded with fucking Sans memes. That, I don't think that's something I'm ever gonna get over. Bob Ross smiles down from the heavens, pleased at Dish's happy little tree. Yeah, I mean, I like it. It'll do. It'll do. A hat in time, but Snatcher wears pants. Ooh, that is the worst. Music teacher's gonna have students learn Megalovania as a passing grade. They're gonna have them learn Megalovania for like... Oh god, like that's gonna need to be considered classical music. You know what I'm saying? Someone's gonna be like, yo, this is what kids back on the so-called internet used to listen to and make memes out of and for some reason enjoy, and it's gonna be fucking Hat Kid insults you over a 3.5-minute beat. Alright guys, but it's been an hour. Yeah, I only managed to get a tree in, but, you know, it is what it is. I wasn't expecting to get much done. In fact, I was kind of expecting to kind of experiment here and there and see what would work and what wouldn't. But you know what? That's not a bad little tree. So, I hope y'all had fun. And, I will see you tomorrow for a Celeste stream where I think we're actually going to do the core this time. Because I had to get 3 other blue hearts before I went into the core. I can't wait for Hat Kid to become a historical figure everyone will love. Oh, man. I wonder if they're even going to teach history in the future.